Hi, it's Dr. Centeno, and I'm a big visual thinker, so I try to illustrate myself important papers so that I can better understand them and so I can better explain it to patients. And this is a very critical paper on Chiari that I've already talked about via video, but I wanted to do some illustrations on it to help patients understand and to help myself understand as well. So we're talking today about this rectus capitis posterior minor muscle, and it's a key muscle right here, and it's in the middle of the back of your skull, and it jacks in through the myodural bridge to the dura, which is the covering of the brain and spinal cord. Now, if we look at it in a close-up, what we're going to see is that we've got the dura in light blue there, we've got the back of the skull, and then the rectus capitis posterior minor muscle that goes from the skull down to the posterior atlas, or C1. And it jacks into or connects into the dura through this myodural bridge. Now, if you've got normal CSF flow in Chiari, it's not really that normal, right? We know that low-hanging cerebellar tonsils here can reduce the cerebrospinal fluid flow in the back of the skull there. That's why skull-based decompressions are frequently recommended for patients who have uncontrollable symptoms in Chiari. But there's some flow that does happen, not a lot, that gets past that area. And what happens is sort of a problem, right? The good news is that if you increase intracranial pressure, let's say you turn your head and one of your jugular veins gets kinked off momentarily, that increases the intracranial pressure. But the good news is that if you have a functioning rectus capitis posterior minor here, it contracts and then that pulls back the dura and that opens up this space here, opens up the gate, if you will, for cerebrospinal fluid to leave your head area. Now, if that muscle gets atrophied, and you can see here I've drawn the rectus capitis posterior minor much, much smaller, then it can't pull on the dura. So it doesn't pull on the dura, and it doesn't open that gate, so to speak, back here. And then if you increase intracranial pressure for some reason, it all backs up and backflows. So that's how this paper works, right? This paper is talking about how that rectus capitis posterior minor yanks on the myodural bridge, that opens up the dura at the back there, and that function is critical for allowing cerebrospinal fluid to flow. When it doesn't do that, you get the backup of fluid and higher intracranial pressure and symptoms. So this is one of the reasons why the authors were so excited about this finding of atrophy within this muscle. And we want to try to do everything we can to get rid of that atrophy in that muscle. And that would be treating that suboccipital nerve that I've talked about. But I wanted to illustrate this so that patients could get a better idea of how all this works. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.
You know what to do. Like, share, comment, subscribe. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.